And I'll be honest with you, everyone in here who's married knows that that's what you do. You do fucking stupid stuff when you're married to keep it bubbling. And everyone always thinks that the grass is greener. And also, when you start living in a new world, like I've started finding myself, all my mates think, oh, it must be great. But I tell you what, every now and again, you get taught a lesson. And something happened just before Christmas that really taught me a lesson. Now, we've played the games that everyone plays. You know that bit where you've had a few drinks and you go, oh, come on, who's your fantasy shag? Come on, I'm not going to get annoyed. We've had a drink, who's your fantasy shag? Come on, come on. Never, say the sister. Okay. Well, it's not funny then, is it? No, that was a rough fucking 6 months, I tell you. We always pick someone off the telly, someone in a film, someone you're never going to meet. My fantasy shag has been all the time, 100% of the time, Cheryl Cole. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Even when she was married to Ashley, although to be honest, then I just would have done it for spite. But I've always fancied Cheryl Cole. Just before Christmas, I got a phone call. He said, would you like to do the Royal Variety Show? Which is an odd thing for anyone from around here to do, to be honest with you, because I think instinctively we're not fans of the royal family. Instinctively we're not fans of the royal family. I mean, let's be honest, we don't mind people living off the state. I just think they take it a bit too fucking far, to be fair. What I mean, we all know lads who are signing on the sick who play football on a Sunday, but they haven't got a castle, you know what I mean? So you've got to balance it up, haven't you? But I turned up to do, because it's for a very good charity. And what happens when you do the Royal Variety Show? You do your bit to the audience, and then you bow to the audience, then you turn to the Royal Boxing Bow. When I turned to the Royal Box, the royals who would come was Prince Charles with his mate, Camilla. And, no, nice lad he is, nice lad, I mean. I didn't think they'd be into cross-dressing the royal family, but he's a top bloke, him, you know, game of darts afterwards, a few pints, a good fella, so he turned, bow. And then you walk off. And you go around the back and you do this thing called the lineup when you meet the royal family and you get placed next to someone. I found myself placed next to Cheryl Cole, my fantasy shag. I said, hello, Cheryl, which I thought was better than my fantasy shag. I said, hello, Cheryl. She went, hello, pet. And it was amazing. It was amazing. There was something immediate that I knew straight away. I walked out the Palladium, I phoned my wife. I said, listen, love, I'm going to tell you something before anyone else tells you. There'll be no super injunction here. I'm going to tell you myself. Because I've just met Cheryl Cole. I've just met my fantasy shag. And I can tell you now, after 18 years of marriage, 3 kids and 1 million arguments, if you were stood there 1,000 times and Cheryl Cole was stood there 1,000 times, I said, I would pick you every single time. I would. I said, because she's tiny, I would smash her to pieces. There'd be bits of Cheryl everywhere. I'm sorry, Cheryl, love, put that back on. It's amazing how a wife can get annoyed quickly after a compliment, isn't it? Thank you. Good night, God bless.